ओके See, in the first class of the MapReduce, when we go to the first class of the MapReduce, we have seen an example. Okay, in the first class of the MapReduce, that is, we have taken some text data. Okay, welcome to Hadoop class. Hadoop is good. Hadoop is bad. Like this, we have say taken some text data, and here we try to find out the frequency of each word. We have taken this small example in the previous class. Okay, what is this aim of this example is, here we have taken the text data. In this text data, our aim is we have to find out the frequency of each word. Find out the frequency. So what we have done here, first the text data is divided into small parts. Okay, the original file is divided into small files called input splits. Each split is given to one mapping. Okay, each split is given to one mapping. Then the mapping is doing its work. The mapping program will contain the map function will be there. The map function will do its work of identifying word count in the given subfile. First subfile is given to map one. It will find count of each word in that file. Welcome one, two, one, Hadoop one. Second map subfile is given to map two. It will find out count of each word in the subfile two. Class one, Hadoop one, like this. The map will find out the count of each word in the subfile given to that one. Then the result of mapping will be given to the shuffling. Okay, what the shuffling will do is rearranging the data so that all the related data will be gathered together. The name itself indicating shuffling means rearranging. Okay, sorting or rearranging the data so that all the related data will come to one location. Like this, Hadoop has come three times. It is segregated to one area. Good is one segregated one area, class one area, bad one area, two one area, ease is actually in two locations. It is segregated to one location. Welcome one. Like that, the shuffling will rearrange the data. Then basing the result of shuffling will be given to the reducer. The duty of this reducer is it will take all the outputs from the shuffling and it will try to combine all the outputs of the that is taken from the shuffling into a single final output. Okay, it will try to compress like this. It is compressing. Okay, all the outputs, see here, Hadoop comma one, Hadoop comma one, Hadoop comma one. It is compressed to Hadoop three, good one, class one, bad one. Okay, is comma two times ease is there. It is segregated to ease comma two. Like that, it will compromise all the and reducer will give the final output. That is the example we have taken in the first class. Is it okay, guys? This example. What is happening in this example? If you see this example, the MapReduce has four phases are there: input splitting phase, mapping phase, shuffling phase, and reducing phase. Okay, totally four phases are there. Is it okay, this example? What happened here in this example? See, when we come to this, this is my own example I have taken. In the place of this example, in our syllabus, we have to take one example data called the. As per our syllabus, we have to take one example called weather data set. We have to take the example called the weather data set. This is the actual direct official example which is given in our syllabus. But instead of directly going with the weather data test, first we have taken a small example called the text data. We have taken text data, and in the text data, what is our previous example is finding word frequency. Now, as per our syllabus, the university example is the we have to take weather data set and we have to find out the highest temperature. So this is the official example which is given in our syllabus. Okay, instead of directly taking this one, we have taken a small example so that this example will be similar to that one only. Only the aim and input and aim will be different, but the process will be same. When we take the weather data set also, the process will be same as that example, only input is different. Here we are giving weather data as input, previously some text is given as input. Okay, here we will get the output as highest temperature, previously we got the output as frequency of each ball, like that aims will be different. Okay, for that purpose only I have taken that example so that we can easily understand this one. Is it okay, that first example? If it is okay, we can easily understand this weather data set. Okay, when we come to this weather data set, see here. Okay, we are dealing with a program that mines the weather data. That means that will analyze the weather data. We are going to see the program. Here the concept is, weather sensors are there in the worldwide. Every country is maintaining the weather sensors. The duty of the weather sensors is for collecting data every hour. Okay, every hour the weather sensors will gather the information. For every hour, it will gather the information and the information will be sent to the weather center. Okay, like this, the weather sensors are generating large volumes of data across the globe. Every day it is generating large volumes of data. Okay, since the weather sensors are generating data for every hour and the weather sensors are distributed in the entire worldwide, okay, we are getting huge volumes of data in the form of weather data. For every day we are getting a huge volumes of data. That's why weather data set is a best example to understand the MapReduce program. Okay, analysis of weather data will become a good example for MapReduce, understanding of MapReduce. This weather data set will become a good example. The reason is the weather data set will contain large volumes of data. Okay, and also the data in the weather report is a semi-structured and record-oriented data. Okay, the data in the weather data set is a semi-structured data and a record-oriented data. That's why this weather data is the best example for the applying analysis using MapReduce. So we are going to see first how this weather data will look like, we will see. Then we will go for phases of MapReduce to reduce that weather data. ఎవరో డిస్టర్బెన్స్ వస్తుంది వాయిస్, హూ ఇస్ దట్ వన్? ఓకే, వెన్ వి కమ్ టు ద డేటా ఫార్మాట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వెదర్ డేటా, వెన్ వి కమ్ టు ద డేటా ఫార్మాట్, వి ఆర్ కనెక్టింగ్ ద వెదర్ డేటా. ఓకే, ద డేటా ఈజ్ అవైలబుల్ ఫ్రమ్ నేషనల్ క్లైమేట్ డేటా సెంటర్ NCDC. Okay, from the website of this one, we can get the weather data. National Climate Data Center. It contains the all the weather data is stored in this one NCDC. Okay, we can get the weather data from this NCDC center. And here, the weather data is stored in a line-oriented ASCII format. When we open that weather data set, the data is in the format of line-oriented. That means in a line. Okay, in a single line, the data will be represented in ASCII format, line-oriented ASCII format. I will show you the sample line, how that line will look like. Clear? The weather data is stored in the form, in which format means the NCDC will store that weather data in line-oriented ASCII format only. In the not normal format, I think you have some idea about the ASCII values. Here, the data will be stored in the ASCII format instead of the ordinary format. Okay, this weather data records will contain a rich set of meteorological elements. Meteorological means atmospheric elements. Okay, many elements will be there in this weather data, like temperature, humidity, air pressure. Okay, air pressure, heatness in the air, coldness in the air, like that many points will be there in that weather data. Okay, but we are, in our example, we are focusing about only one point called temperature. Okay, this weather data will contain a lot of points. Next, when we are using this weather data set, we will focus on only one point called temperature. We will consider only the temperature. Clear? So before going to apply this MapReduce on this weather data set, first we will see the already we told that data is stored in the form of a line oriented ASCII format. So we will see one sample line, how the data is stored. We will see a sample line. Okay, for our convenience, the line has been divided into multiple lines to show important fields. Okay, మన కన్వీనియన్స్ కోసం ఏం చేస్తాం, ఆ సింగిల్ లైన్ ని కూడా మల్టిపుల్ లైన్స్ కి డివైడ్ చేసామండి, సో దట్ వీ కెన్ ఈజీలీ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద లైన్ ఫార్మాట్. సో వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ ఏ శాంపిల్ లైన్. సీ, వన్ లైన్ ఆఫ్ రికార్డ్ విల్ బి లైక్ దిస్. మనకు కావాల్సిన మనకు అర్థమయ్యే కొన్ని వాల్యూస్ మాత్రమే ఉన్నాయండి. ఓకే, దీని ఇదేంటి అంటే దిస్ ఈస్ ద వెదర్ స్టేషన్ ఐడెంటిఫైయర్. ఓకే, ఐడియా ఆఫ్ ద వెదర్ స్టేషన్, యుఎస్ఏఎఫ్ వెదర్ స్టేషన్ ఐడెంటిఫైయర్ అంటే United States Air Force. USAF stands for United States Air Force. This is the first. This field is the identifier. This field is also the identifier. This field is also the weather station identifier. See, managawasin field is an important field. This field indicates the observation date, on which date the observation has made on the climate. Ye date lo observation chesaru. See, the first four indicates the year 1950. Next month 01 indicates January 1st. January 01 indicates date. Like that. Actually idu mottham kalipi oke line lo untundandi. Mana convenience kosam ante example lo oka line chustunnam, break chestuntu manaku ardhamayya important points varaku chustunnarandi. Okay, the next field indicates the time. Similarly, this field indicates latitude. And our weather sensor, ekkada information gather chesindi, dan latitude enti, area yokka latitudes, longitudes. Clear andi? Wind direction, akkada wind direction ela undi. Sky ceiling height, akkada sky height ent undi. Visibility distance, lighting ela undi. Akkada air temperature ent undi. Ante aa time lo report chesina time lo air temperature anta, dew point temperature ante lopala humidity temperature antundi, atmospheric pressure antundi, air pressure antundi, like that. Okay, and many points will be there in the line oriented record. In each line, many points will be there. Okay. All this one, actually here we have divided this into the parts to understand the how it will look like. But actually, it is in a single line only. As I told you previously, the weather data will be in a line-oriented ASCII format. It will be available in the form of a single line-oriented ASCII format. But for our convenience, we divided that one into the sublines, multiple lines. So one line, it is actually one line in the weather data set. We taken that one line and we divided that one line into multiple lines to see what are its various parts. Okay, many parts are unknown to us, so we have not taken, only we have highlighted only those parts which we can understand. Station identifiers means we can understand, date time we can understand, latitude longitudes we can know. Manaku ardhamayye points varaku highlight chestunnamandi. Remaining what is they have the other things, but we don't know directly, so we are not highlighting that one. Just here the aim is to show you how one line, what the one line contains. All the data will be in a single line only. Clear? That is the thing. Like this. Okay. See, for example, he has given some sample data which is taken. Generally, the weather stations are maintaining all the data since from 1900. To 2001. Okay, for every year from 1900 to 2001, they are maintaining the all the data. Okay, daily data, they are maintaining the data in the form of day, next in the form of month, in the form of year, they are maintaining all the data. Clear? So for our example here, what we have taken is, we have taken the entries of 1990. For example, we have taken only the data for the year 1990. We have taken, for our example MapReduce, we have taken some sample data for the year 1990. Clear? Already we told the data will be stored in a line oriented ASCII format. Okay, all that line will be that line will be saved in the format of gzip. Okay, in the format of gzip. I think so. Zip format, you have some idea about zip format. What is the zip format you will do? Zipping, zip and unzip. I think you have some idea. That means compressing. Okay, the line will be stored in the form of a zip format. That means it will be in a compressed format so that the data size will be reduced. Okay, here the line will be stored in the form of gzip, means GNU zip. The full form of this format is GNU zip. I think you have in the Unix, you have some idea about this GNU. Actually, this GNU is a full form is the GNU not Unix. It is called as GNU not Unix. Okay. It is called as a GNU not Unix. Okay, GNU organization has developed an operating system which is similar to Unix, but it is not exactly same as the Unix. They named that one also as the GNU. So the GNU stands for the GNU not Unix generally. Clear. Those GNU people has developed this format, so they named this format as GNU zip. All the aim of this zip format is to store the data in compressed size. Generally, when we want to store the data, we are using the WinZip or WinRAR we are using. Okay, like that you have some idea, I think so, about the zip format. Okay, the line data will be stored in the form of GZ storage. Okay, every line will be compressed and stored in the form of GZIP. Clear. So for our convenience, for our map reduce program, we have taken the entries of the 1990. We have taken the data from 1990. Okay, generally the weather station is maintaining data from 1900 to from 1900 onwards, year onwards, they are maintaining every year data. Okay, large data is there. For our example, we have taken the data of 1900 only. Okay, centuries 1900 only. We have considered between 1900 to next one, we have taken some sample data. This is all not about our map project. This is briefly to introduce the weather data set. Clear? See, don't get confused. See, just he is introducing the weather data set. What is this weather data set? How the data will be stored in the weather data set? That is the first point we have to see. When we come to the weather data set, weather sensors are collecting the data every hour. So for weather data set, large volumes of data is there. That's why weather data set will become a best example for analysis with MapReduce. Why? Because already we told MapReduce is used for analyzing large volumes of data. So since the weather data set is also contains large volumes of data, it is a best example and are a good candidate for analysis with MapReduce. Okay, generally the data in the weather data set is a semi-structured and record-oriented data. When we come to this one, how the data, what is the data format means? Okay, in the weather data set, data is stored in the form of a line-oriented ASCII format. All the values are stored in a single line. For example, if they are maintaining the daily data, okay, for every hour the data will be controlling like that. The day data will be stored in the form of a single line. If they are maintaining the data month wise, okay, all the January data will be stored in a single line. All the February data will be stored in single line. So 1 year will contain 12 lines. Like that, the line oriented, they will store the data in the form of line oriented ASCII format. Clear? If this is day wise means, every day data will be there in a single line, so that every month will contain 30 lines. Next, for maintaining the data of the month wise, okay, they will segregate and every month data, complete month data will be combined into a single ASCII format line, so that the year will contain 12 lines. Okay, first line will contain the complete data about the January month, second line will contain the data about the February month, third line will contain the data about the March month, like that. Two lines will be there, like that. Okay, the complete data is stored in a line oriented, in a single line oriented. Clear? the line with a single line will contain all the fields will be there. Many information will be there in that single line, not of information will be there. Okay, for our convenience, he has shown one sample line. The sample line will be like this. He breaks the line into many lines, but actually it is a single line only. Okay, some important attributes are shown here. That single line identifier will be there. Weather station identifiers are there. Observation date is there. Observation time is there. Latitude, longitude values are there. Elevation is there. Wind direction is there. Quality of that wind quality. Yeah, height, sky height, its quality. Next, visibility distance, its quality. Air temperature, its quality. Temperature in degrees, its quality. Okay, atmospheric pressure, its quality, like that. ఈ వదిలేషన్ వాల్యూస్ ఉన్నాయి అనుకోండి, దీస్ ఆర్ ద అదర్ అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ విచ్ వి డోంట్ నో. మనకు అర్థమయ్యే అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ మాత్రమే హైలైట్ చేసాము. మనకు అర్థం కాని వాల్యూస్ చాలా ఉన్నాయి, అట్మాస్ఫిరిక్ వాల్యూస్, అవన్నీ మనం కన్సిడర్ చేయట్లేదు. ఓకే, కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవ్వాల్సిందే లేదు. ఈ వదిలేషన్ ఏంటి అని చెప్పి మనకు కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవ్వాల్సిన అవసరం లేదండి. మనకి ఏవైతే రెగ్యులర్ గా మనకు తెలిసిన వర్డ్స్ ఉన్నాయో వాటిని మాత్రమే దే ఆర్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. ఓకే, ఇవి దీని ఇది మనకు రాసుకున్నాం, మనకి అవేంటో తెలియదు కాబట్టి సింప్లీ హీ లెఫ్ట్ దెమ్. క్లియర్? That is the thing. A single line will be like this in that the weather data set. A single line will be in this format. Okay. When we come to the weather stations, the weather stations are maintaining the data from since 1900. Okay. Not only from 2000 up to 2001. Still now also they are maintaining from since 1900. The weather station NCDC is maintaining all that data. Okay, in which format it is maintaining the data means? Okay, it will maintain the data in the form of gzipped file. Okay, the fields of the lines of that year will be stored in the form of gzipped file. Gzipped means in the zip format. That means the zip format aim is to compress the data size. The aim of the zip format is to compress the data size. Clear? So that the zip format, in the zip format size it is storing. He has given some sample entries for the year 1990. For example, if you take a particular year 1990, there the data lines will be stored in this zip format. He has given some sample lines. Okay, the sample lines will be like this for the year 1990. If you take each line, okay, the complete line will be like this. The complete line, if you open, it will contain all these things in the complete line. Okay, the sample of lines will look like this one. This is briefly the before going that one. What is this weather data set and how it looks like? Using Hadoop MapReduce. Clear? We have to go for the analysis of big weather data set with Hadoop MapReduce. That is the thing we have to see. Tomorrow we will see about this one completely, about the how we are analyzing the weather data set using our Hadoop MapReduce concept. The concept is very simple. Tomorrow also there is no more points. The simple points will be there. The MapReduce will contain mapping phase, reduce phase. Internally map phase will contain input split and MapReduce will contain the shuffling and reduce. By using those, it will do that work. That we will see about this analyzing the data on the tomorrow next class. Okay, this is briefly about the how a weather data set will look like. It okay, guys? Briefly. Okay, again we will continue the things on tomorrow. Thank you.